Namaskar. Welcome to today's edition of Holistic Healing with Amar Chandel. I was wondering that we all know that our body is our most prized possession. This is something which is irreplaceable. Anything else can be bought again, your car, your house. Body is something which once gone is gone forever. But we are very careless about how to handle it. We virtually destroy various body parts by either disusing them or misusing them. Today I'll like to speak about a part which is essential for you to be able to perceive this beautiful world, that is your eyes. Eyes are something without which you cannot enjoy anything in this world, and yet we do all in our power to destroy these eyes. They are a strong part. They don't go away very quickly, but we keep on working in that direction, and you must have seen that in majority of the people, eyesight keeps on getting worse and worse. Some degeneration is natural. As we age, some degeneration is bound to be there, but our endeavor should be to slow it down, not speed it up. We do things which worsen the situation. Before we understand where we go wrong, we should understand the functioning of the eyes, the structure of the eyes. The first thing we must realize is that eyes are designed by nature or God to look at things which are at least 6 feet away. We were never meant to see things which are very close to us. Then we invented study, books, writing them, reading them. So we have to focus on things which are only 9 inches away. Now I am not saying that we must banish education. Some students may say that since it has a bad effect on our eyes, we are not going to study anything from now onwards. No, that's not the idea. The advantages of education are a million times more than the problems on the eyes. What you need is taking due precautions to counteract the effect that this focus on things close by have on us. So, reading was assault on our eyes, but we went a step further. We moved from books which were blue or black letters on a white background. We moved on to screens. Now, screens were light emitting. They were throwing lights at our eyes, so it was much more harsh on your eyes. With progress, we took it to extremes. Old timers like me would remember, earlier the TV used to be the size of a handkerchief, a small TV, hardly bigger than your handkerchief. Now it is wall sized. So all those rays coming on your eyes plays havoc. And on the one hand we were oversizing things, and on the other hand we were undersizing things. As you must have seen, our desktops have been all replaced by laptops, smaller and sharper and closer. That also creates problem for your eyes. But the biggest assault, it is almost equivalent to a murder, is your smartphone. You are focusing on something which is only 6 inches away, lettering is too small, and this focus on smartphones makes us very unsmart people. Our phones are smart, we are stupid. Again, I'm not saying that you'll be banishing your phones. What I am suggesting is that only the essential tasks should be done on your smartphones. Only something you just have to open on your smartphones has to be done there. Please remember, phone is for calling or receiving a call. It's not your replacement for a laptop. You say we do all our SMSing, we do all our WhatsApping on the phone. Please cut it down to the bare essential. If you're opening all your email on your phone, you are being harsh on your eyes. Essential ones, I can understand. Not the optional ones. Keep them off. Another mistake, which is even more serious, is the contrast in light. Working on your smartphone is bad enough. If the other background is dark, then it becomes even bigger problem. And as you know, parents at times tell children not to use smartphone. So what they will do is, when everybody has gone to sleep, they'll put a blanket on themselves, open their smartphone and quietly work on that. Please remember, your eyes would be in trouble. That is why you must have noticed, by the time we are 40, most of us are wearing reading glasses and other glasses also. So this is something that we deliberately bring upon ourselves. So we should be careful about that. Light has to be taken care of. The more important thing is that focusing on anything for too long is troublesome for your eyes. It's not only about reading or writing or computers. Even when you are driving, you must have noticed, you're not moving your eyes. Your eyes are focused on the road. So if you keep your eyes focused, you must have seen, after a few hours of driving, your eyes feel tired. They even get red and swollen. Those are signals that, please, you are troubling me. We should listen to this. And while driving, it is very important to take some rest every once in a while. Maybe 1 hour after every 60 minutes or so, you have to stop and take rest. And even otherwise, even when your eyes are focused on the road, try to keep moving your eyes this way or that way. This would be the way to lessen the burden on your eyes. At the same time, you have to do certain exercises also, because please remember, your eyes are also muscles. Like, if you don't move your arm, what will happen is your arm will start aching. Similarly, if you don't move your eyes, there will be trouble. So there are a set of exercises which you'll be doing so that you can move the muscles of your eyes. Otherwise, the trouble created by this focus on one place would be not only creating problems for your eyes, but it can lead to headache and even migraine. So a few things you must do is, once you have focused your eyes on certain things for about half an hour, make sure that you remove your eyes from that spot for about 30 seconds, look somewhere else at something which is far, far away. If it is an open window, look out of that, maybe a mountain or anything. But even if it is within the room, you should look at the farthest corner. And if you're looking out, if you can focus on some tree or anything green, it'll be better. Green, incidentally, is the most soothing color for the eyes. You must have noticed that even in hospitals, in any eye operation, your eye caps are green in color. So this moving of your eyes away from that itself would be an exercise. So you should keep shifting the focus. Come back to your screen again. You must have noticed that screens have a hypnotic power. When you have a lot of work to do, once you are at it, you don't want to stop. You want to finish that work. Yes, you'll be able to finish your work, but in the process, you may also finish your eyes. Don't do that. Don't spoil your eyes so much. Just because they don't protest, you cannot keep on bothering them so much. The only way they protest is feeling hurt, getting red, getting swollen. These are all signs that you are creating problem for you. We must do certain exercises to counteract this difficulty that we put our eyes to. Let's go on to the exercises. So all you have to do is sit straight, not move your neck, not move your head. Only your pupils will be moving up and down. So be here, take your attention up and then let it come down slowly. As if you are trying to look at something above you, and slowly bring it down. Controlled movement, look towards your nose. Again move up. Come down slowly. Here I am doing slightly faster to save time. You have to do it as slow as you can. Move up and down, 10 times up, 10 times down. This would be a movement of the eyes. Having done that, move left and right. Look towards your left shoulder. No movement of the neck, no movement of the head. Your face remains straight. Eyes go to the left and then they move horizontally to the right. Slow movement, control movement. Look left, straight, go right. 10 times left, 10 times right. Now it will be crisscrossing the whole thing. Look to the top on the left, look to the bottom on the right. Neck remains straight. Up and down. Up and down. Up and down. 10 times up, 10 times down. Come back to the normal. Reverse the direction. Right side up, left side down. Two things we should be very particular about. One, extreme movement. You'll be going right to the very top and again you'll be coming to the bottom. And secondly, slow movement. It's not calisthenics, you're not rushing your way. Do it as slowly as possible so that your eyes can get full benefit. Having done that, now you alternate between these two, first this side, then this side. This should be the movement. At the same time, you must make sure that you are blinking regularly. Don't stop blinking. If you keep focused on something for too long, it's not good for your eyes. Blink as often as you can. At the same time, whenever you get time, clench your eyes, relax them, clench and relax. This would help you in relieving the pressure on your eyes. Now, rotation. Imagine that there's a big clock in front of you and you would move your pupils like this. 10 times clockwise, 10 times anti-clockwise. This movement will again help you. The same precaution has to be taken, big circles and slow. Do not rush with that. Now you can draw some other geometric figures. First of all, let's make an 8, a figure of 8. Your eyes would be moving like this. Please remember, for recording purposes, I am doing it slightly faster than I should. When you do it at home, do it as slowly as you can. There's enough time with you. And even if you're not doing the whole set at one go, do it slowly. so many other geometric figures. We have done circle, we have done 8. Then maybe a square. In the other direction, focus on the boundaries of the square, triangle, you can have any number of figures. Keep on moving in various directions. In between, two, three things help. One is that if you press your temples gently, that's a great reliever of tension for your eyes. Even otherwise, you must have noticed when we are tired, we press it. This is natural, scientific. So press your temples, it will help. Also, if you rub your palms, make them warm and put them on your eyes, and then open the eyes in the darkness, close it again, that also is a great stress reliever. Very slight pressure of fingers on the eyes also helps. Even these few seconds of relief would help you in keeping your eyes in good health till the old age. Another focus should be changing the focus of the eyes. Take your thumb forward, focus your eyes on the nail, start bringing it towards you, let it come as long as you can keep the focus. When it is impossible to focus, take it back. So this change of focus will again be a good exercise for your eyes. 10 times bring it close, 10 times take it away. Even otherwise in daily life, change the focus. Don't keep your eyes totally peeled onto a particular thing. Every few minutes you should look at something which is far, far away. This one is particularly done. Even otherwise, if your eyes move up close and far, as any photography lover will tell you that when your eyes are focused on a distant object, the depth of field is much better. So that you should try. Another variation is you focus here, keep the neck straight, move it sideways. Your eyes move with the nail. Keep going. Eyes will be strained. Take them as far as you can. You can almost bring it to the side. Try to keep your neck straight. Take it to the side and then gently bring it back. All the time being focused on your thumb, on your nail. 10 times front, 10 times side you go. You do the same thing on the other side also. Focus here and your eyes move. Then you do a few counter exercises. But before that, a few more cares about your eyes. You must have heard of an Indian herb called Trifla, which is normally taken as a laxative to keep your digestive system okay. So all you have to do is take a teaspoon of Trifla and soak it in some water in a small cup. Next morning, slowly strain away with water, filter it through a muslin cloth and use that for splashing your eyes. Take a eye cup, put this Trifla water in that and wash it. The good point is that the residual matter can also be used for your better digestion. If this is too much of a trouble, in place of Trifla, you can just take rose water, mix it with some plain water, use that for washing your eyes. That is again a great help. Finally, a few fun exercises for young children. Because for them, this may be too much of a rigmarole, they may not like it. So you can make the whole thing a game. They must be learning their alphabets now. It could be ABC or in Hindi AAE. So ask them to make those letters with their eyes. Ask them to keep the neck straight. You have lowercase letters and then capital letters. Ask them to make a A. So say that your eyes are a laser and you are drawing those letters. A is there. Go for B, up and down, and then a circle. A to Z you go, then you go into the capital letters. We make the same ABC in capital letters. I made A, then a B. This kind of movement will help relieve the pressure that develops when we use our eyes non-stop. We have to give them due rest, and you will find that your eyes are there all your life. Even in old age, you can keep better eyesight. They are a blessing of God. Don't ruin them yourself. Namaskar.